Good evening. 369 cases in a single day. That's a number Queensland has never seen, but it is the state's new COVID normal. And the Chief Health Officer says it is necessary people are infected with Omicron to increase immunity and bring an end to the pandemic.
Queensland, COVID-free 1 week, virus-riddled the next.
Brisbane, Bundaberg, Cairns, Central Queensland, Gold Coast, Gympie, Ipswich, Logan, Maranoa, Mareeba, Moreton Bay, Noosa, Redlands.
All now hotspots as cases climb. Another 369 today, almost double yesterday's numbers.
We are living with this virus. This is the next stage of the pandemic. Everyone wants to get on with their lives.
Since the border opened, there's been more than 800 infections, but crucially, just one person is in hospital needing treatment.
Not only is the spread of this virus inevitable, it is necessary.
The Chief Health Officer sees Omicron as the way out and our path to normal life.
Once the virus is spreading, once we all have some degree of immunity, the virus becomes endemic, and that is what is going to happen.
Testing clinics interstate were swamped again today with travellers needing a swab to cross borders. The Premier is standing by the rules.
25% of people are travelling across the nation, 10% of that are coming to Queensland.
Those numbers don't add up with her claims yesterday.
10% of the lineups are for people who want to get their PCR tests to travel all around Australia, not just for Queensland.
Also under pressure, the state's hospitals, the Nurses and Midwives Union calling for more staff and meetings with the government to address issues with PPE, vaccinations and resourcing.
Alarmingly, a recent union survey found 72% of health staff were not confident their workplaces would cope with a COVID outbreak. A further 58% raised concerns about patient safety.
The health workforce is tired, they're extremely stressed, and they are burning out.
Sounding the alarm again for a health system barely hanging on. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.